Hey guys, my name is Cal, and in today's tutorial we are continuing on with our shape list example. In today's tutorial we are going to be able to filter our list based on multiple filter buttons. In previous tutorials I've shown you how you can create a list view, how you can search and filter a list view, and also how you can sort your list view. Links in the description below. Well, in this one we're going to make it so that you can filter based on multiple fields. So in our shape list example, we're going to be able to select, say, triangle and square, rather than just only being able to use one of the preset filter buttons. Yeah, we're going to make it so that it all works together so that you can search, sort, filter a list. First thing we're going to do in today's tutorial is just build and run our current project so we can see where we're up to. Currently you can filter by one button at a time, but in this tutorial we want to make it so that you can filter by multiple buttons. Let's get rid of that white space at the top, just so we've got a bit more space for our list view. So I'm just going to open up our styles.xml. We're going to type in item named window action bar, and I'm going to set this to false. And then I'm going to type in item again, and then we're going to say window no title and set this to true. And if we build and run this again, you can see that it's gotten rid of all that wasted space at the top there. Nice. So next what I'm going to do is just open up our main activity. I'm just going to change the text color. This is a bit of a UI improvement. Of all our buttons to red. Probably should have done this last time, but anyway, just copy and pasting down the text color so you know red is a button and black is text. Next, I'm just going through and checking to see that all of the buttons have an ID, and it looks like we've given the filter buttons an ID, but we haven't given the sort buttons an ID. So that's what we're doing here, just putting in an ID for each of those four buttons. And then we're just going to head back into Java main activity. First thing we're going to do is declare all of our filter buttons. Usually I'm not a huge fan of declaring multiple variables on one line, but because there's so many, I'm going to do it anyway. So yeah, just putting all the filter buttons there. And then on the next line, I'm doing all of the sort buttons. And then I'm going to copy and paste them down into the init widgets, just because I don't want to forget any. So there's 10 here. So if I've got them copy and pasted, I won't forget any. And then we're just going to copy and paste down that cast to a button. And we're going to do that for each one. So just getting rid of the comma, and then we're going to go back through and change the IDs. So pretty straightforward on that one. Yeah, just making sure that each button can find the right component. Next, we're going to head back up to the top and just declare a few colors. So they're actually ints. So I'm just declaring white, dark gray, and red. In our onCreate method, I'm going to create a new method called initColors. In here, we're going to initialize all of our colors. So white is equal to context.compat.getColor, and then give it the application context, and then just find that color by its ID. Just doing the exact same thing for red and gray. Next, we're going to create a new method. This is called lookSelected, and it's going to receive a button. And then just going to copy and paste that down and then say lookUnselected. So given our pass button in our lookSelected, I'm going to set the text color to white and set the background color to red. And then copy and paste that down into lookUnselected and making the text color look red and the background color dark gray. Next, we're going to create a new method called unSelectAllSortButtons. And we're just going to call lookUnselected on all of our sort buttons, and then we're going to do the same thing for all of the filter buttons. So just calling lookUnselected and giving it each one of the appropriate filter buttons. Nice. So heading back up to the onCreate, I'm just going to call lookSelected on ID ascending and all button, because they're the initial buttons that are selected. So we're actually going to do the sort buttons first because they're a little bit easier. So just heading into ID ascending tapped, I'm just going to call lookUnselectedAllSortButtons and lookSelected and giving it the appropriate button. And then I'm just going to copy and paste that down for the other three. If we go and run this, you can see we're making it a bit easier for the user to see what they've selected, which sort field they've selected. Cool. So now we're going to do the filter buttons. So grabbing our two lines again, I'm going to head up to the allFilterTap method and just change that lookSelected to all button. And then I'm going to only grab the lookSelected method, copy and paste that down into all of the filter buttons. So just giving the lookSelected method the appropriate button from the method that's being called. And then we're going to head back up to the top, and instead of a selected filter, we're going to have multiple filters. So I'm changing this to an array list of selected filters. And because I've taken away the initializer of all, I'm just going to put that in the onCreate. So I'm just going to say selectedfilters.addAll. Because we've changed the name, we should be seeing error messages. So the plan here is to just scroll through and fix each one as it comes along. Looks like the first one is in init search widgets. go to change selected filter dot equals all to selected filters dot contains all, and then we're just going to create a loop and loop through all of our selected filters. And then instead of giving it contain selected filter, I'm just going to give it the filter that we've looped through. So essentially checking for multiple filters, not just one. Scrolling down again in our filter list method, changing it to selected filters dot add status. And inside our shape loop, we're going to create another loop like we did earlier. So going through our selected filters. And then instead of saying contains status, I'm going to say contains our filter that we've looped through. And then in the all filter tap method, I'm just again changing it to selected filters dot add all instead of assigning it directly. In the check for filter method, in our if statement, we're just going to say if selected filters dot contains all rather than is equal to. This check for filter only gets called from our sort buttons. So when we call filter list here, we won't ever need to add anything to selected filters list. So I'm just going to add a conditional if status is not equal to null, you can add the status to the selected filters. Nice. And one thing I forgot to do was in all of our filter tap buttons, I need to make the all button look unselected. So just copying and pasting that down into all of the methods there. Next, we're going to change the unselect all sort buttons method in all filter tap. This should actually be unselect all filter buttons. And scrolling back up to the filter list method, we actually need to add in another conditional. So selected filters does not contain status. So this way we can't ever end up with, say, two triangles in our selected filters list. Bit of a roundabout way of doing it, I know, but back into our all filter tap method, I'm just going to call selectedfilters.clear before I add all. And then in the rest of our filter tapped methods, I'm just going to call selectedfilters.removeall because all is a bit of a special one. We can't really ever have triangle and all selected at the same time. This last step is totally optional because I just realized I've written the same three lines of code over and over again, which is never a good thing. To refactor code, you just got to highlight the code that you want to refactor and then right click and under refactor extract method, and then you just give it a name. And then you accept the signature, place all of the occurrences, and you can see we've got our select filter UI method has been called. I'm just going to change the button to button rather than triangle button. But yeah, if we go and run this one last time, you can see that you can filter by multiple fields. We can filter by multiple fields and have something in the search text. And then we can have something in the search text, filter by multiple fields, and still sort the list. So I feel like we're giving the user a pretty good experience. Cool, so that was filtering a list view by multiple fields. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Cheers.